Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I am back with Omar Isuf. What are you laughing about?
If they could have seen you 2 minutes ago, you're like, I'm tired.
I'm so...
And then you're like,
trying to wake myself up, baby. So guys, today I am back with Omarion Isafion, and we are going to be doing a...
That's not my name.
We're going to be doing a specific topic.
Uh-huh.
Where we actually got this question in our queue. You need to sit
You're
back.
You're so forceful.
This is you.
You just want to look bigger than me and you can't.
No!
Go ahead.
No. I'm not saying that. We received a ton of questions. As you guys know, we did a two-part Q&A. And one of the questions, Omar said, hey, can we just go ahead and bookmark that and save it for a longer video? Because I feel it's a video that can just be a discussion of its own. And it was the question of...
How to fix being skinny fat, basically.
Not necessarily. I feel that I'm skinny fat.
Yeah.
I'm starting my fitness journey.
Yeah.
Should I start with a bulk or should I start with a cut?
Yeah, that's more accurate.
Yeah. We're just going to kind of have an open discussion about this, and hopefully you guys learn a few things.
So the first thing is that you have to be easier on yourself. You have to be kind to yourself,
yes.
Right? Because our perceptions of ourselves and the reality are oftentimes not the same. And we also have to define ultimately what we want out of our body.
Yeah.
You know? And so you can't just pay attention to the magazines, your favorite Instagram models, your favorite influencer, your favorite person on YouTube. You have to ultimately define what you want. And
yeah.
If you're comfortable with your body, more power to you.
For myself, I'm in a place right now where I still feel like I am technically skinny fat, but I love my body the way that it is. I have no issue. And I think that skinny fat over the past few years has become a pretty negative term when it doesn't need to be at all. Because most times when people are talking about being skinny fat, they're not owning it. They're trying to figure out how to change it. Trying to, you know, have a healthier body, a stronger, you know, physique, all of those things are great, but also take your body at what it is and appreciate that it's beautiful and perfect the way that it is. If you are looking to have some form of a transformation, is you have to figure out what your goal is. Are you trying to just lean down, or are you really focused on building muscle? And then that's a question of like, well, what if I want to do both?
Yeah.
You still kind of have to decide which one you're going for. If you're just starting out, newbie gains are super real and you will most likely put on some muscle regardless.
And I think the question ultimately is I'm just starting out. I don't like how I look.
Mm-hmm.
Where do I start?
Yeah.
And I think for most people, they need to get first off in the habit of tracking their macros. I know ultimately you do not need to become obsessive with it, but you just need to be able to quantify, all right, I weigh this amount, how much do I need to eat in a day just to maintain what I got?
Yeah.
Okay, then how much would I need to eat in order to lose weight? Because calories matter. They matter, they matter, they really do matter. And intuitive eating works once you know the basics.
Why does there also have to be that ultimatum of bulking or cutting? Why can't it be just eating at maintenance and still getting results from that? Because you're still gonna get results if you're eating at maintenance and, you know, going to the gym 4 to 5 times a week. You're gonna change your body regardless because you weren't going to the gym at all before. So why do you think that people always have that ultimatum too?
You stole my answer.
Oh.
So what I was gonna say is, for guys, I would say most of them should just start with a bulk, even if they're skinny fat. For women, I think they should be eating at maintenance, because at maintenance, you could still, as a newbie, synthesize new muscle while having a more favorable body composition. Remember, when we define skinny fat, what it basically means, skinny and then fat. Skinny, you don't have enough muscle. Fat, you have more adipose tissue on your body. You have more fat than you would like. But how do we transform this? Well, muscle, interesting enough, it gives us shape.
Mm-hmm.
Right? When people talk about a big old booty, no matter what, even if you want to have a big old booty, you take a look at those glutes and there's muscle underneath that.
Mm-hmm.
Muscle gives shape, it gives symmetry, it gives proportions. And that's why, even if you don't want to be a bodybuilder, and you're not going to look like a body, you don't have these insane genetics to make you look super jacked or masculine, as they say, you should want to try and build some muscle. One, for your skeletal structure, it's just healthier as you age. As you continue to age, you'll actually lose muscle mass, so it becomes a fight just to maintain what you got.
Mm-hmm.
But besides that, it gives you shape. So I would say for most people, they should start out eating at maintenance, just learning the ropes, learning the basics, learning how to train effectively. And then over time, what you're gonna notice, even though you're not getting any more fat and you're not in this crazy surplus, you'll look better. So
yeah.
You'll have a little bit more definition. When people say, like, I've heard women say, like, oh, my arms are looking better. Well,
it's filling out those areas.
Yeah, biceps, triceps a little bit, make the arms look toned. And that's what, when people say, I want a tone, that's basically what it means. It means have a more favorable body fat level and probably have a little more, hypertrophy in that area.
Right. I also think going into the mental health side of things, it can be really intimidating when you're going into the gym to create an ultimatum of bulking or cutting for yourself. So also doing a maintenance routine is just more sustainable too, because there's not that pressure of eating in a surplus or eating in a deficit. You're able to enjoy the process for what it is, learning, like he said, how to track your macros, learning what foods are beneficial for you, what make you feel not so good, just getting into a routine at the gym. I just think there's far less pressure doing something like that, because that's what happens with a lot of people who do track macros. It's very easy to get very in your head and either become kind of obsessive or to just altogether say, screw this, this is way too much for me to think about. Whereas when you're doing something more at maintenance, it's just, I just think it's more...
sustainable.
Sustainable, that's the word. It's way more sustainable. There's less pressure and you're just able to enjoy the process for what it is.
One of the big things when I worked as a trainer would be to shift the mindset by shifting the goal and learning to like the process by becoming more focused on performance and then aesthetics, how you look follows, rather than the reverse. I wanna look a certain way. What do I need to do in order to get that body?
Okay.
Instead, what do I need to do in the gym to become better? And then as a side product, what ends up happening? You look better. Mm-hmm. And that way, for those that are too image focused or food focused, it shifts the goal to something they can objectively quantify. Because when you look at yourself in the mirror, you're not happy with your body, right? You're like, oh, I wanna change this, I wanna change that. And it's a perpetual game of being unsatisfied.
Yeah.
Whereas in the gym, you're satisfied with your progress. And lo and behold, when you take a look at your body, you'll notice these changes. So shifting the focus, the perspective is important.
I agree. Let's say that this person has now, you know, been at maintenance and has learned their routine and everything for 6 months to a year. And now they're ready to then make that next change where they're like, okay, I'm happy with my body. I see the changes. I'm ready to just take it to the next level. At that point, it is appropriate to cut because they've built the muscle, but also recognizing that you will lose some of the muscle too.
At that point, it's time for the creatine, for sure. Time to get on the hard drugs. 6 months, anyone that starts out, as long as there's not an excessive amount of weight you need to lose where you're very uncomfortable, for most people, they should start 6 months basically at maintenance or in a slight surplus. Essentially, and then from there, they could reevaluate once their strength has gone up, because that'll lead to progressive overload, which will help them transform their body. After the 6 months, they could take a look and say, am I comfortable with my myself and my progress? Cool, all right, maybe I'll do another 6 months.
Yeah.
If they want to begin to lose weight, then you're going into a fat loss phase.
Right.
And I would go slow and steady. So we want sustainable progress, and I think for most people out there, most women, in my experience, to get the body, and in ways I'll say, they're a little bit more fortunate maybe than guys, or the pressure, I think there's a lot more pressure on women.
Yeah.
But for guys to attain their idealized version of themselves, takes at least 5 years, like just period.
You know,
like
yeah, you said that before.
Right? How most women define their physique and what they wanna look like from where they start, it's inside 2 years. Yeah, so you just need to be methodical, you need to be consistent, you need to stay on the path, you need to enjoy the process, you need to find what works right for you, and you need to understand that it's a transformation, it's a journey, it's not a temporary thing. We want sustainable, long-term progress. After 6 months, as you said, you're like, you know what, yeah, I look better, this and that, but I got this, I wanna lose it. Do your thing, go on to 4 to 6 month fat loss phase, lose the weight that you want to lose. Understand that you might end up where the initial question was being skinny fat. There's certain body fat percentage blocks where you kind of end up looking worse when you start out. The glycogen stores, just your muscles, they look a little empty. So you feel smaller and you look fatter.
You feel flatter.
Yeah, or flatter, right? Fluffier.
Like the muscles and all that, yeah.
But once you get past those different blocks, and you move down to the next block of body fat level where it's noticeable.
Wait, so you're saying during the 4 to 6 month phase, they'll probably experience that feeling?
Yeah, you will, and especially because we're hard on ourselves, you will take a look at yourself and you're like, I look worse.
Yeah.
Like, I look worse.
Yeah, right.
So you just gotta ride that out. Like I said, muscle gives shape, and when your muscles are deflated,
right,
and a variety of different things. Maybe you're holding a little bit of water weight, time of the month. There's just so many variables coming into play that you think to yourself, all right, I'm being good, I should look better. It's like, nah, it's gonna take a little bit of while.
Yeah.
A little bit of time, yeah.
For sure. All right, guys, well, I think that's gonna be it for this video. Just a quick little chit-chat discussion with you guys, and hopefully helping a lot of you guys who are beginners or also just in the first, you know, 6 months to 1 year of training. Seriously. So if you guys have any other topics like this that you'd want us to discuss, go ahead and leave them down below. We will definitely make something like this happen. Also, Omar and I were discussing, obviously, since I live in California, that there are some videos, instructional videos, that he can film and kind of be featured on the channel. So if there's anything like one of the
I'm a rising YouTube star. I appreciate the shout out.
We're trying to get him to
1,000 subscribers.
No, actually 100 subs.
That's a big goal.
We'll get you there. So if you guys want, if you guys have any specific requests, just also leave that down below.
Also, I was going to say, we have that project. Is it released now or is it not released? What do you think?
No, it's not released yet.
Not released yet. So
I think it'll be released in like 2 weeks.
Yeah, mid-September, there's going to be a massive announcement of something that I think will revolutionize.
Wow.
For most people, for most of their goals, for what they want, it's going to really help them out.
Yeah, what we're offering is going to be something that doesn't necessarily exist to this degree in the industry right now. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, throw it a thumbs up. I've said that 20 times now. Omar's content is, his Instagram and YouTube will be linked in the description box, and we'll catch you guys in that announcement video. Say it.
Besitos.
Besitos, bye.
Jeff Bezos.